Sometimes being in the Now Hear This feels like standing by a cool mountain stream eating a York peppermint patty.
Sometimes it just feels hot.
Now, a lot of times when people say hot, they mean hot like my spicy Tex-Mex chili.
Or hot like the temperature of the sun.
But when we say hot, we mean those moments when you are slammed into the Now Hear This quite unexpectedly and it's not such a taste sensation.
That makes me hot.
I am obsessed with Scott Stoney. Scott is directing our All City High School musical. He's about twice my age and he's a total dreamsicle. So we're sitting around rehearsal one day and Scott says,
I need a haircut.
And I'm all, I cut hair. I'll cut your hair for you. And Scott's all,
great.
And I'm all, great. Before I know it, I am standing in Scott Stoney's kitchen and my hands are in that thick, delicious Scott Stoney hair. And I'm cutting and cutting and cutting and cutting.
Like she's in heaven with her hands all up in Scott.
And I don't know how to cut hair. I've never known how to cut hair.
That makes me hot.
My parents are in from out of town, and they're staying with me and my fiancé in our first apartment. They're pretty conservative, and me living with a guy before I get married is not their first choice, so everything has to be perfect. I buy tulips and freesias for every room. I wash the walls. My parents arrive, and everything is flawless. In the morning, we're all lounging comfortably, drinking coffee in our robes and pajamas. Aw, I look lovingly at my fiancé.
Everything is beautiful, and then suddenly it's not.
And notice his testicles hanging out of his boxers.
That makes me hot.
The lunch bell rings, and for some reason today, I feel the need to run to get into the lunch line. No one else is running. There's no need to run, but I decide to run. So I bolt from my desk, running free past the rest of my 7th grade class, and I run smack into Kathy Chenard, and she goes down hard. But knocking her down is not what makes me hot. What makes me hot is that when I knock her down, her prosthetic leg shoots out the bottom of her pants.
This was not the way things were supposed to go down.
Go into the bathroom, lock the door, get buck-ass naked, and do what every teen guy does when he gets the chance to be alone. Masturbate to Lee Majors. But when I locked the door, apparently I had not locked the door.
You think you covered everything, but there's something you forgot.
Because my dad opens the door to use the bathroom, and there I lay on my back, naked. I flip over to the toilet and yell out, I feel sick. Why I'm completely naked remains unaddressed. My dad laughs and says,
oh, okay.
And shuts the door. I vow never to touch myself again. That lasts approximately no hours.
This was not the way things were supposed to go down. Someone make this moment disappear.
No hours.
Where is there a rocket that will blast me out of town and get me a million miles away from here?
I introduce myself to Betty Comden and I say, it's an honor to meet you, Miss Condom.
That makes me hot.
While playing the Fair Rosalind and As You Like It, I straight up wet myself.
That makes me hot.
I accidentally call my math teacher Mommy.
That makes me